Hey, hey, gangs, it's me, James of Regret, and I'm back to pick on everyone's favorite console fanboy punching bag, the one, the only, Crap Gamer himself. Today, we're taking a look at a now deleted video of his, where he complains about Sony porting more games to PC, and just from that alone, we're sure to find some entertainment out of this. So sit back, relax, and get comfy, kings, because no matter how down you are in life, know that at the very least, you're not as pathetic as this guy.
So while this was probably expected, and even I expected this to some extent, it's still a little bit disheartening to see that Sony, for some reason, is following in Microsoft's footsteps in putting their games on PC.
God forbid Sony want to expand into a massive market which they haven't been able to touch, simply because that market prefers to play on PC over anything else. Such a stupid move. Why would they want to do that?
Now, we don't know the exact amount of games or what type of games. It does look like they are still focusing heavily on creating the PlayStation 5 versions of games first. They have confirmed that Nixxis, who they picked up, is a studio that they're going to use to help port some games to PC and things like that, which, you know, a lot of people picked up on that when they initially launched. Myself, personally, I thought, you know, they picked up a studio that could support, you know, maybe help create a new Uncharted, something along those lines. But, you know, a lot of people obviously knew that this, what this meant.
Well, who would have thought that a company known for porting games to a different platform would be assigned to porting games to a different platform? Absolutely boggles the mind, doesn't it?
Now, what is it going to mean long term? I don't really know. Like, I think that you definitely hurt your console's brand by having these games everywhere. And we can, again, look at the Xbox as a way of comparison. You know, EA back in, I believe it was 2016, leaked that there were about 31 million Xbox One sold, right, in 2016. And this was like right prior to the release and the decision to put every game on PC at the same time.
I love how he tried to imply that Xbox games coming to PC was somehow killing Xbox sales, when really, the reason was the dog shit choices they made at the start of the Xbox One era. I mean, facial recognition locks, online only, having less firepower, and other anti-consumer bullshit happened much earlier, before the decision to sell their games on PC. In fact, you could say that selling to PC happened because Xbox consoles were selling like shit, not the other way around.
Now, the funny thing about this is, what we see is, it's not exactly as cut and dry as what a lot of people have maybe expect. Like, we don't, obviously, the fact that they're going to use Nixxis to port games means that there's not going to be day and date stuff, so it's not going to interfere with the game itself or the PlayStation version. But I still think if you have a situation where, you know, everybody just knows in a couple few years the game's going to come elsewhere, that's less of a reason to actually pick up a PlayStation 5, and thusly actually hurts their brand.
Well, that would simply mean that consoles would have to find a different way to compete. Xbox already figured this one out with that Xbox ecosystem they're building along with Game Pass. They're making choosing Xbox the more consumer-friendly choice available on their market. What can the corporation you're simping for do? Crap? Brick your console with an SSD update? Besides, really think about it. The Russians, the Indians, the Chinese, that's a whole lot of people who don't even give gaming consoles a second thought. Releasing games on PC will help reach them as an audience and thusly improve your brand in the long run. But who are we kidding? This is Crap Gamer we're talking about. He'll twist everything he can until he can fit it into his warped worldview, or he'll ignore it altogether.
We're gonna get into this as soon as possible. Let's get started. What's up, everybody? It's me, Crap Gamer, back with another video. Thank you guys so much for checking it out. I really do appreciate it. Please like, share, subscribe. I would appreciate that as well. It helps out the channel. It means a lot to me just to keep things going and just having fun and all that kind of good stuff. So yeah, you know, make sure you guys do that. And I really do appreciate everything you guys do. So thank you guys so, so much. Anyway, so obviously Jim Ryan came out and made some announcements and stuff like that. And some of it obviously going to be a little bit more controversial than others. Now, for me personally, getting back to my story, 2016, EA leaked that there was 31 million Xbox Ones out in the world. This was directly prior to the announcement of Quantum Break and all future exclusives going day and date. So from 2013 to 2016, which is, you know, about 3 years, you know, probably a little less than 3 years because it launched in November of 2013. But basically, so the first 3 years of the life cycle, Xbox One was at, you know, 30, 31 million consoles sold. From that point on, 2016 to 2020, basically, you have a situation where they only sold an additional 10 million units in that amount of time. Now, there could be other reasons behind this, you know, obviously some lack of games and stuff like that, but again, where they officially ended off according to AMD in March of 2020, where AMD said they shipped 150 million GPUs between the two, and Sony announced 109 million that same week, and that left 41 million just by math. Even if you want to bump that up to 45 million, still, you go from 31 million to 45 million, you know what I mean? 3 years, you get 31 million, and then the next 4 years, you know, you basically get 14 million. Like, that's not a very good sign. And one of the biggest things is, you know, Xbox didn't have any exclusives and things like that, so that is very unfortunate.
What gets me about this is that he goes nowhere with this point. He seems to be implying that because Xbox games are coming to PC, Xbox consoles are selling like shit. This conclusion was made through an extreme bias against PC gaming. Crap Gamer got shat on by Phil Spencer over Quantum Break coming to PC, and he's held a grudge about it ever since. So it would make sense that his bias would make him conclude that Xbox games coming to PC as a big reason for Xbox's not selling. Now allow me to explain why the Xbox One performed so poorly using simple facts and logic. The Xbox One had a dog shit launch, and that's a fact. Compare it with the 360 or even the Series X, and you'll see that the Xbox One was underperforming in so many levels. This was largely due to the Xbox One being the overall inferior console. Because of this, the PS4 ended up absolutely annihilating the Xbox One in sales earlier on, which means that more people had their hands on it. This then snowballs into post-launch sales because for a lot of people, the console they choose to buy is determined by what console their friends had. Because more people had PS4s, it stands to reason that it's statistically more likely for people to have friends that owned a PS4. It is because of this that long-term sales for the Xbox One would be hurt as well. Makes sense, right?
When you see that happen, and again, I do think that a lot of people kind of really don't understand the ramifications. Yes, people like, just like with anytime you bring up something that's woke or whatever, or, you know, hey there, why are these people doing this just to be politically correct or whatever? People call you crybabies and try to like harass and make fun of you for that. Like, I never understood that. It's the same type of situation with this, right? Exclusives are what make these consoles worthwhile.
That's a very subjective thing. Some people think exclusives are what make consoles worthwhile, while some others only care that they can play the latest games properly. The market for gaming is so massive and so varied that you can't exactly point out a clear-cut answer from a subject as nuanced as this one. Take myself for example. I spent 8 years slumming it with a dinky old laptop, playing most games on the lowest possible settings. In my eyes, getting a console was a matter of being able to play new games right off the bat without having to resort to editing INI files or downloading performance patches. A lot of people share my opinions as well, and the worth of a product is derived entirely from the opinion of a customer. So if a console's only selling point is its exclusives, and I don't like its exclusives, then simply put, that console has no worth to me. On the complete end of the spectrum, a person can also decide that the only reason to buy a console is to play whatever exclusive is available on it. To this person, consoles with the better exclusives would be of greater worth than a console that has worse exclusives. So again, it's a very subjective thing.
Like, there's three different consoles to get. I own all three. The main thing about it is they all offer, you know, something that the other one doesn't offer. And if you're putting all that on someplace else, then what good does it do, to be quite frank with you, right? Like,
and they still very well can, even if their games are getting released on PC. PlayStation had that thing where they were pushing VR. And Microsoft is developing their own ecosystem. Both consoles can still offer something to the consumer without having to rely on exclusives. And on a side note, I know this is going to be controversial, but in my opinion, exclusives are probably the laziest form of added value you can add to a console. Seriously. Oh, this specific third-person action-adventure game, or this specific first-person multiplayer game, is only available on this specific console. So what? I can get similar kinds of games on other consoles or PCs. Show me something that no other console can do. Show me VR. Show me that HoloLens nonsense. Show me something that I can't get or approximate on other consoles than yours.
Here's the thing that I also kind of wanted to point out. We've never lived in a world where PlayStation and Xbox had their exclusives available both on PC. Now, I can understand, like I don't think people understand the ramifications of this, right? Like, you would see people on PC buy a PlayStation just before those PlayStation exclusives. Now, the funny part about this is, you know, there's never been a part where you could get these games on PC. So the fact that you're now going to be able to do that is, like I said, disheartening to some. And, you know, now we have the details on exactly what's going on. You know, I do think that it's just a really sad situation. So
what Crap Gamer doesn't realize about exclusives coming to PC is that there are certainly a lot of players who would buy a console to play those exclusives, but there are even more out there who don't even want to bother with those consoles. India, Russia, and China are massive markets, and PC are so dominant there that consoles practically don't exist. Not catering to that market is money not gained, and corporations only exist to make money and maximize profits for their investors. Money not gained is a bad sign.
With this, Sony's looking forward to working with Nixxis to release more PlayStation titles on PC, according to Jim Ryan. Sony Interactive Entertainment is looking forward to work together with Dutch studio Nixxis to bring more PlayStation titles to PC, according to Jim Ryan. Speaking with Famitsu, the Sony CEO commented on the company's effort to bring more PlayStation games to PC, saying he's happy with their current efforts, although they're still in the early stages. The company is also looking forward to working with Nixxis to help them bring more titles to PC. Sony Interactive Entertainment CEO also commented on the current PlayStation 5 supply issues, saying that while they have achieved an unprecedented supply of products at launch, it's not enough for the current worldwide demand. The situation seems to be improving slightly, according to Jim Ryan, and they are working very hard to increase supplies together with their partners. Sony announced, obviously, the acquisition of Dutch developer new studio Nixxis earlier the month. The studio worked on PC ports of various titles like the Tomb Raider games, Marvel's Avengers, Deus Ex, and much more. It's not surprising to hear straight from Jim Ryan's mouth that the studio will help port more games to PC. The latest PlayStation 4 game released to PC is Days Gone, developed by Sony Ben. You know, and again, that really just depends on how you feel particularly about these types of games.
Complete side note right here. But notice the difference in speech between when Crap Gamer is reading and when he's just running off his mouth. He speaks much faster, is more concise, and also takes less pauses. I don't fault him for not being naturally quick with words. I stumble with my own words a lot too. Difference is, I edit out my mistakes and my pauses because frankly, you guys don't need to hear it. Crap would be significantly more tolerable if he tried some basic audio editing, or even tried structuring his videos through a script. But I guess that clashes with his 4 pointless videos a day grind set.
For me personally, I think that it's a bad move, especially when, you know, I'm going to get the counterpoint, right? They're going to go, well, this is going to mean more games, more exclusives and stuff like that. But, you know, again, I heard that years ago about Xbox as well, and it didn't lead to any more exclusives or anything else, right? It just led to less players to play against, more cheating with crossplay, and, you know, again, I know a lot of people don't understand this, but it does cut down on your console base, right? Like, look at this.
More cheaters due to crossplay, I can understand. But less players? What? I got more matches on Halo MCC after crossplay was activated than before. Same with Splitgate. That game blew up thanks to crossplay, and you're never more than a minute away from another match. In fact, that game blew up so hard thanks to crossplay that there's a fucking queue to even log in. In what universe is expanding the available pool of players to play with, resulting in less players?
It's true. PlayStation, as it stands, is like the only place where you can disable crossplay with PC. And because they have enough of a player base to go out and do that. I can't imagine a world where these games are going to be on PC with crossplay and the amount of cheating and things like that that's going to go on that people are going to have to deal with, you know, just to make Sony an extra, you know, a couple million dollars. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, it doesn't really make sense to rock the boat like that, especially given really what was kind of out there to be able to do that. So
Sony doesn't even have a good multiplayer shooter in its library. The only way for a cheater to ruin your day on a Sony game is if you are the cheater modding the game's files. And this only affects you. And again, China, India, and Russia are massive markets that Sony could be making money off of. But you can't create loyalty there overnight. You have to treat your customers like kings for years in order to get them to love you that way. That's why Xbox Studios became one of the largest publishers in PC in less than half a decade. They started treating PC players no differently than they treated Xbox players, and they're raking in profits because of it. But here's one thing I'll agree with Crap Gamer though. I know, unbelievable, right? It's a stupid move for Sony to be porting their games over to PC the way they are. But I only agree with this notion on the surface because Sony treats the PC market as if they're second-class citizens and not like kings like Xbox does. If Sony wants to properly compete with Xbox on the PC market, they need to start offering better than Horizon Zero Dawn's messy PC port.
Obviously, you know, this is a little bit of a bummer of news for me. I'm kind of disappointed that they're going to go in the same direction of Xbox. I mean, obviously, it's not day and date stuff. And they obviously know also that it is going to be a situation where if you're developing for your console and PC at the same time, it can elongate the actual production time. And it can also run into other issues where your game can suffer. Because obviously, the PlayStation 5 has this amazing solid-state drive.
Yes, this legendary PS5 SSD that is so amazing. The ponies love to hype up the PS5 SSD so much, they make it sound like it'll cure cancer. The PS5 SSD is not only possible on the PS5, it can be done on a PC as well. The only leg up the PS5 has is that it's built with the SSD in mind, whereas most people don't exactly build PCs around a specific SSD. I guarantee you though, if someone built their PC specifically around a top-tier SSD, it would probably nuke a PS5 out of water.
So if you were to be, you know, like, I think I'm more okay with this if it was like PS4 titles and older, but if you start talking PS5 titles, doesn't that take the solid state drive out of the equation, right? Like, I mean, there's no way that Ratchet and Clank could have been done on a PC because there's no set hardware on PC, right? For the way that they do that, nobody would have been able to play it, because I'm sure that probably next to nobody has a solid state drive the equivalent of that.
Yes, you can do Ratchet and Clank on the PC. All you'd need to do is install it on an SSD and you'd get practically the same results. Hell, you might actually get a leg up and play it at true 4K 60fps with ray tracing on, which, you know, you can't do on a PS5.
So yeah, it is a little bit disheartening to see that. And you know, again, it's just one of those things where I guess like we're gonna have to learn to kind of roll with it, I guess. I don't know. Like for me, I think that it is a little bit of a disappointment. As long as it's not day and date, I think I'm okay with some of it. But I just feel like, you know, with these companies, with corporations, which is why I say never trust these corporations. I just, you know, it's just a situation where for me personally, I just kind of go, well, you know what? It's best not to trust any of these leaders, and because they all just want money.
Oh my God, a megacorp and its execs are in it for the money? That's unheard of. I thought Sony was in it to be a charity. God, how fucking stupid are you, crap? Corporations are literally for-profit entities. They exist to make money. Do you think Sony makes PlayStations out of the goodness of their hearts or to make money out of it?
Despite the fact that PlayStation is coming off like their best profits ever or whatever, we still see that, hey, guess what? That's not enough because they want even more money, and then more money after that, and then more money after that. So, I mean, it's always going to be something with these companies, and that's the way that they kind of do things.
Do you really think that they're going to be content with resting on their laurels after a success like that? That's not how corporations work. Once they make record profits, they're going to strive to outdo those records. That's how successful people and how successful companies think. I know you're content with being a pathetic console fanboy, but not everybody is content with being a loser.
Like I said, it's just unfortunate to me. Like, why would you follow the last place company and do what they do? I mean, I get the idea that you're trying to grow.
Because the company you called last place is generating record profits without having to ship as much consoles as Sony does. I mean, they're printing money with the games that you claim aren't as good as what Sony has. So wouldn't it make perfect sense that Sony would be printing money as well if they followed suit into the PC market?
What you're doing, but you also have to remember that you have a console fan base that you are out there trying to appease and trying to keep happy as well. So hopefully you guys understand that and understand where I'm coming from. Thanks for watching. Fact them up. Crap Gamer out.
Yes, we do understand where you're coming from, Crap. We see that you're dumb, business illiterate, and that you've been wrong with your facts almost every step of the way. Anyways, we're finally done with this video. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and share if you feel like it. And also never become like Crap Gamer, by the way. This has been Cheems of Regret. Good luck and Godspeed to you all. Signing out.